Since Datuk Seri Najib have spoken in Malay, I will open up in English so that you have everyone here. But if you want to ask me in Malay, in the Malay language, you are most welcome, and I will answer you in the Malay language. Okay, as a statement, can I say this first? You know me too well. I work better under pressure. This is a serious challenge, all right? Although I'm disappointed, I'm not down. If there is a similarity between me and Datuk Seri Najib, we are identical in terms of working best under pressure. So I think our challenge on the appeal will be mounted in a higher format, in a higher gear, because we believe our case is strong from the very beginning. But we were troubled when the defense was called with the grounds that were provided, all right? Because the grounds does not seem, it is an honest judgment. Let me say this so that I don't get into trouble, yeah? I think this judge is honest, but I think he honestly made various mistakes, okay? And from the judgment in the, defense, or rather at the prosecution stage, he has gone into the current final judgment, and we find that the error has compounded. Perhaps because he cannot unwind the reasoning that he has provided. Yeah? So I feel that we have got the strongest of chances to win the appeal. This is a case where the judge himself have said, in no uncertain terms, it is a case that provided factual metrics as well as the legal issues like no other cases before this. And when I said this is a case that's the biggest trial in the world, I'm not exaggerating. And there are several legal issues that you may want to consider in your assessment of what we are saying. This is the first case ever where a shadow director who is not a director of SRC is considered as a person who can call the shots over and above the board of directors. This is a principle I've never heard of before. Although shadow directors is a concept, but never applied in this form, especially in a criminal case. That's number one. Number two, this is also a case where principles of company law has been thrown aside, because the learned judge said that a shareholder can literally take away the function of the board of directors, and the board of directors need not have to be liable for it. You and I know that in any company, especially in companies like SRC, the board of directors are the primary persons who makes decision, and their heads are the one on the chopping block, not the shareholders. So this is just two that I give you as example, which troubles a lot of people, trouble a lot of our defense team, because it is a clear-cut case. We feel error has been made, all right? And there is no evidence whatsoever that Datuk Seri Najib was the one who instructed the 42 million to be paid to him. If it is a gratification, you may wonder how come the charge never say who paid the gratification to him, who agreed that he should receive the gratification. The charge never even say that, and neither did the judgment. Who decided with Datuk Seri Najib for the gratification to be paid? So these are just teasers to you so that you'll think about it. How wrong, but honestly, the judge has come to make this decision. All right. So if you ask me, I feel that the fact that he found Datuk Seri Najib guilty of all seven charges, to me, in a very black way, I am happy, because I've got a better chance because he found all seven guilty. He denied every single defense point has not been taken up by the learned judge. So to me, this is a better this is a better scenario to fight the judgment in the appellate court. You got another 10 more judges to hear this case. This is just one judge, because in the court of appeal, 3 judges. In the federal court, there are 7 judges, normally over cases like this.
But how long will the appeal last, and what will be the prediction?
I told the judge I would like to have this appeal within 3 months, the first round of appeal. Second round of appeal, perhaps another, the next 4 months. So we are looking at a total exhaustion of all the appellate matters within 7 months. But the first 3 months, the first case. All right? And I am looking forward to this appeal like I have never looked forward to any appeals before, because this is a very exciting appeal that we want to proceed as quickly as possible.
What do you think of the sentences?
Sorry?
What do you think of the sentences, the jail terms and the 210 million to fine imposed?
Okay. I don't think the judge has got a choice because of the views he has taken. The amount of money involved, no doubt, is only 42 million. It is not the 4 billion that we are talking about. But he is influenced by the fact that the abuse of power related to the 2 billion and the 2 billion, although the gratification is only 42. I think he is stuck with his own judgment, and therefore he came to that that punishment that he handed down. We will of course appeal both on conviction as well as punishment. We think we got a good chance for both. Yeah. Sorry. All right. Well, the trial before this judge has been fair. Yeah, you have to be, to give him credit for that. Yeah? He gave us all the latitude to hear. And my only complaint is he does not seem to apply the criminal concepts and philosophy, criminal law concept and philosophy. He seems to have applied more of a civil concept. Because in criminal law, if you have a reasonable doubt, just a mere doubt, you have to throw the case out. Whereas in civil cases, you do the balancing act. Who tells the truth? Who has got a better case? You balance it. Even if it is 10% more on this side, you give it to this side.
And Sri, yes. Judge, earlier he used words like lacking in credibility, flawed, far-fetched, unsustainable, defying logic, astounding. As the lead counsel whose argument has been exposed to such comments, what are your comments from the judge?
Okay. I find that is, how would I say, a fantastic sort of statement made by the judge, especially in the face of the following thing. For instance, you remember we led evidence by at least 4 witnesses, excluding Dato' Sri, that there was a meeting with King Abdullah. And at that meeting, there was a smaller meeting where personalities moved to the center of the hall. And King Abdullah, in the Arabic language, mentioned the help that he would render. And immediately after that, the help that he would render was, among other things, financial. Because on the way out, you remember there was evidence led that Anifa Aman said so, Dato' Sri Najib said so, namely this, and Khair. The minister here also said the same thing. When Dato' Sri Najib inquired, did I hear correctly that King Abdullah wanted me to open a private account to receive this money? And Anifa Aman said, yes, that's what I heard. Now, how could you dismiss the meeting having taken place? Merely on one basis, whether the meeting took place on the 10th, 11th or 12th, because people cannot remember, because this is an unofficial meeting, because the actual official meeting took place on the 13th. We did say this took place just before the official meeting. Now, as to the date, that's not so relevant. It is a mere irregularity, because if we want to fix, if we want to perjure, we can do a better job. Among all the witnesses, we can say let's agree on one date, where we can prove. The fact that there is a slight inconsistency show that the witnesses did not get together to fabricate. Okay, that's one example. The second example, you remember the meeting in the same palace after King Abdullah had passed on with the two prince and people from MACC and lawyers and so on. That meeting took place. But the judge doesn't seem to think and pay any credibility to that version. Even the MACC witnesses said so.
Yeah, one question.
Yes.
We noticed that Dato Sri Najib, he swore three times in different occasions to guarantee he didn't know the all the things. So will his swear play a function for the appeal, in the appeal?
Can you repeat? Can you repeat? Don't wear that, please.
Yeah.
Repeat.
Dato Sri Najib swear three times.
Oh, okay.
He didn't know. So will this swear influence the result of the appeal?
Well, it should. Because if you know the Muslim philosophy and the religion, this is not something easy for any Muslim to swear by God's name. And that is a formula of taking an oath. Because consequences, if you lie, is great. Muslims believe that. And Dato' Sri Najib said this. And there was another occasion, you remember Dato' Sri Najib went into the mosque and swore. That was about the Alta Tunya matter. So he's prepared to do this because that's the truth. It goes towards credibility. Whether you can believe a witness or not, these are some of the elements you look at. Okay? Any other question?
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.
Late.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.